This new proof of the flat Earth comes from Grotto 1 from a frozen lake in Manitoba, Canada. I strongly encourage everyone to head over to his channel and subscribe to show your support, because he obviously went to a lot of effort for truth here. For this curvature test, Grotto 1 essentially set 4 lights at around 1 foot above the water and ice. He set up his camera at about 8 miles away from the furthest light and 5 miles away from the closest light. The lights were spread out at about a mile apart. At each location, Grotto 1 drilled down to the water just to confirm that he wasn't on some irregular ice formation, and to also ensure that his test was on a level surface. The furthest light from the camera was the red light at 8 miles from the camera. The blue light was at about 7 miles, the yellow was at 6 miles, and the orange light was the closest one at 5 miles away from the camera. You should definitely watch his video where he goes into much more detail, but here he is sitting in his truck at a distance of 8 miles from the red light. Notice that the lights are all on the same flat plane. There is no earth bulge and no physical globe horizon. Next, Grotto 1 lowered his camera to only 12 7/8 inches above the surface. At that small elevation, the globe horizon would have to be closer than 1.27 miles, and the furthest light, the red one, should have been 29 feet below the horizon, as taken into account the 1 foot height of the light. Notice how the lights are all on the same flat plane. There's absolutely no supposed bulge here. And if there is no curvature on that frozen lake, then there is no Earth curvature anywhere. Look at the red light. That light should be 29 feet below the horizon. It's just amazing that they got away with this lie for so long. Finally, Grotto 1 brought his camera down even lower to just 5 7/8 inches off of the ice. At this very low elevation, the red light would have to be a whopping 33 feet below the horizon. That's 34 feet minus the 1 foot height of the laser. Without question, the globe fails again. Furthermore, under the official model, the globe horizon would have to be closer than a mere 0.86 miles. There is no globe physical curve here, blocking your view. As Grotto 1 demonstrated on this frozen lake, regardless of the conditions, the Earth is observably, testably, repeatedly, and measurably flat. Yes, we were all lied to. Yes, they control our education. Yes, they control our media. Yes, they control our governments. Yes, they control all of our major institutions. But they still don't own your soul and your ability to think independently and to shake off the conformity and to break free from these mental controls. And that is how, with God's help, we can win. And we must win.
I'm showing 3 pens on a table. When I lower the camera to be basically in line with the pens, I can see that the table is not quite straight. Part of this video series shows what happened when I did a similar test on Rock Lake using lights instead of pens. Here the truck is still on Rock Lake, 8 miles from the red light. So here I would like to begin the return trip to collect the lights and also to document the lights with a video camera along the way. And before I begin, I think I'm standing beside the truck with the door open, and I believe I'm resting the video camera on top of the open door. I took a measurement today in the garage to get an approximate height for the video camera. So I'm going to use 62 inches. I would like to use that number in the curve calculator.